Good day, everyone. Jewel here with you on the 5th day of August 2020. Yes, I am okay. But boy, oh boy, Isaias has really showed people what it could do. We had a lot of damage around me. I'm okay. Don't worry about me. I'm okay. Just a little bit from me. I mean, like, not even 30 minutes. In the town of Bath and all of those areas, it's like disaster. Then you go a little bit further north of me to Bertie County. Two people died. It's a disaster area. It looks like a war zone. It looks like a war zone. From the southern part of North Carolina all the way up, right? And as everyone knows, I want to thank Pamela. She sent me a video. I haven't had a chance to look at it. I just got my electricity back yesterday afternoon, right before the sun went down. Sister Golden Hair, she's one of our subscribers. She called me, and it came on while we were talking. I was just about wilted down to nothing at that time. You guys know I have heart problems, and the heat was something. But it went all the way up. Pamela sent me a video. There was a tornado around New Jersey up in here. I mean, tornadoes everywhere. You people on Long Island and New York City. You know what the wind force was like with this storm? And it went all the way up, as you can see. I can't even name the all of the places. But right now, as of this morning, 3 million people are without power. Still people without power. Right around here where I live, it was awful. The winds at Ship Bottom, New Jersey reached 109 miles per hour. I told you folks, this was going to be a tornado producer. Right where I live, we had about 30 tornadoes in a very short period of time. They were deadly and very, very destructive and caused much, much damage. And yes, we had winds from Isaias. But the main thing is, please listen when I do these videos. I'm really doing them to keep you safe, folks. Isaias was more than just a nothing storm. Now, this morning, as we look up here, it's post-tropical right now. The winds are 40 miles per hour. Can you believe it still has 40 mile per hour winds after traveling over all of this land? Quite a storm indeed. The pressure's going up. This is all good. Speeded up to 28 miles per hour. The pressure's 1,000 millibars. But it's a mess, folks. And it makes me very sad. The conditions were ripe for tornadoes. You can't do anything about a tornado, you know? That's actually worse than a hurricane. It pops up on you. Boom. There it is. At least with a hurricane, you know it's coming. But all of my thoughts and prayers are for everybody. Everybody. From right around this area of North Carolina all the way up. My prayers are with you. We do have this system here. I don't think it's going to do a lot right now. It's a small area, but it's well defined, and it is a low pressure system. It's a few hundred miles southwest of Bermuda, and it's got disorganized showers and a few thunderstorms. Now, the low has been nearly stationary during the past several hours, but it's forecast to drift southwestward during the next couple of days. And any development of this disturbance should be slow to occur. And that's because of all of the dry air increasing in the upper level winds. It's dropped down now to only a 10% chance in 2 days and 5 days. Be aware. Later in the week, for the weekend. We have another one coming off the coast of Africa. Not showing up here yet, I'm just telling you. And it looks like it's going to be tracking over toward the island area here. It may develop, it may not. I'm just telling you what I'm seeing. And I will say this right now. Do you guys realize we've already had as many tropical storms and hurricanes as we usually have by October? Well, this is the 5th of August. Looking like, by things that I have researched ahead of time, I'd say somewhere along the 20th of September, somewhere in that week area, maybe a little sooner, maybe a little later, looking like we could have a very major hurricane to occur, possibly somewhere in the U.S. that's going to be coming off of Africa. So just stay tuned, folks. I will keep you abreast of what's happening. Now, I'm not going to go into a lot of stuff this morning because, quite frankly, I don't have time. I'm going to give you what you need to know so far as severe weather goes. You can see over in the Central Plains, we do have this chance of severe weather today, even in the darker green. The darker green, severe winds and hail with these thunderstorms when they pop up. Also, of course, in the yellow, as you can see, anywhere in the green, doesn't matter what color it is, we could have a severe thunderstorm pop up. No chance right now. Now, this could change, but it doesn't look like any of these darker green and yellow areas will produce a tornado. But that's not out of the question, but it doesn't look like it now. But wherever you see the darker greens and the yellows, down in Louisiana, parts of Texas, moving on up, as you can see, we do have a 15% chance or greater happening as the day goes on of severe wind and severe hail. So please keep this in mind. I love you guys so much. I thank you for everything you do for me. I have much I have to try to do. I do want to thank the I Am of Me and Michelle W. Michelle let me know when the surge was coming in, and that's another thing. We had much greater storm surge than it looked like people were talking about. And I tried to tell you folks that too, that I thought it was going to be a little bit higher, but it's okay. I did not get any water in my house. I did not have severe damage. I had some, of course. I got damage, okay? But it's like nothing compared to the people just down the road from me and just a little bit north of me. That's devastating. I'll try to have more for you on this a little later on if I can. My electricity may flicker on and off, and my internet is still not doing too well. And the internet guy never did make it to my house because of the high winds. So maybe one day it'll get back to normal. But folks, stay safe today. Be prepared. Hurricane season 2020 is not over yet. Thanks for everything you do for me, the donations that you send me through PayPal. That's what helps keep me going. I appreciate it so much. Loving me, your prayers you send to me, everything is a blessing, folks. If I didn't have it, it would be kind of rough. And it still is, but what I'm saying is it helps me make it through. And thanks for just watching my videos. If you haven't subscribed, please do so. Click the bell. Check off all. Make sure you get all the videos that I put out. I will keep you informed as long as I can. And if I lose power, I can't help it. You can tell I'm kind of tired sounding. I love you guys so much. Please have a good day, a safe day, and a blessed day. And peace, love, and kindness to each and every one of you. Thanks for watching.